is that? What does it mean entering paradise without any punishment? It says, usually this practice of catharization is very painful to the person. And it's more painful than the sickness in of itself. Therefore, those people, they depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they do not lose hope from finding cure other than going to the last resort, which is the catharization. Because usually this is done as the final result, something that is the end of it. But those people, they say they never lose hope if they're going to get the healing. Therefore, they do not do something that is at the last resort. This is some of the explanation that was given. So those people, they do not fall into superstition. What is that يتطيرون? Usually the Arab, they used to have a practice. If somebody wants to do something, he goes and see a bird, and he throws something at the bird. If the bird takes off to the right, he will proceed in his business. And if the bird takes off to the left, he will not proceed in his business. This is called superstition. What does it have to do, whether what you're going to do is good or not, with the bird flying to the right and the bird flying to the left? It has nothing to do with it. Therefore, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in another hadith, "الطيرة شرك." To practice this طيرة, this superstition, is an act of shirk, an act of association with Allah Azza wa Jalla, because there's no connection with that, this and that. Nowadays, people, they have certain ways of practicing superstition. There's many ways of people to practice superstition. They do not look at the bird. Somebody walks out the house and he sees a black cat. He says, this is a bad day for me. Some people do that. Some people say, well, today is the Friday the 13th, I better stay home. This is superstition. We find a lot of people who seemingly very educated. They build a big hotel and they eliminate number 13 from it. Why is that? This is, all of it is an act of superstition. A person will wake up in the morning and open the paper and he looks at his horoscope and he reads it. This is, if it's good, he will follow and he do whatever he wants to do. If it's not good, he leaves what he had the intention to do. This is also a practice of superstition, a practice of shirk. So those who are from those who will enter paradise without any reckoning, they do not practice superstition. They depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They depend on what Allah will bring to them. It has no connection between you deciding to travel and seeing a black crow outside your window. There's no connection, none whatsoever. Realize that superstition is haram, totally. Whereas ruqya is not haram, as long as it does not have association in it. Also, catharization, it's not haram. Yet the quality of the 70,000 people, what do? They leave the, they do not seek ruqya from others, and they do not do the catharization, and they do not fall into superstition. And else, what else? And عَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ, and they depend upon Allah Azza wa Jal. What does it mean to depend upon Allah Azza wa Jal? What is dependence? A lot of people do not understand dependence on Allah Azza wa Jal accurately. Let me give you an example and see if this is dependence or not. I want to travel from here to Orlando. My car has no gas in it. I would say I'm going to depend on Allah and go without gas. Is that dependent? Huh? Why not? Can't Allah, couldn't Allah make the car go without any gas? He cannot? How can he cannot? Can't Allah make the car go without any gas? Not to Orlando, to China? Huh? So why you tell me it's not depending on Allah if I want to go over there without putting any gas in my car, if Allah can do it?
What do you
think? Al-amal bil-asbab. What did he say? You have to affect the causes. You have to affect the causes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he created the creation, he created causes and he tied the causes to their consequences. رَبَطَ الْأَسْبَابُ بِمُسَبَّبَاتِهَا. Allah Azza wa Jal created the causes and he connected the causes to their consequences. And he told you, when you want the consequences to come to your life, you have to affect the causes. You have to affect the causes. You have to bring them into effectiveness. If you affect the causes, then depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make those causes fruitful. Not depend on the causes, and here we're going to give you three scenarios. Some people depend on the causes, and some people they do not depend, and some people they affect the causes and they depend on Allah Azza wa Jalla. We'll give you the example that is very clear. Somebody who wants to have offspring, he says, well, it's obvious, if you want to have an offspring, you have to get married. So he wants to get married, he gets married, and he establishes relation with his wife, and he depends on himself for the baby to be created. Is this person dependent on Allah or he dependent on the causes? He affected the causes and he depends on what? On the causes. Okay, we have another person. He says, I want to have children. And Allah can give me children without any marriage. So I'm just going to sit here and Allah might give me a child of my own. Is that person dependent on Allah Azza wa Jal? You tell him you have to go and affect the causes. We have a third person, he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislated for us. If we want offspring, we have to get married, and we have to establish relation with the woman, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make that marriage fruitful. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can make the marriage fruitless. So this person is affecting the causes, yet he is depending on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make those causes fruitful. Another example, a person who has a headache. Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. He goes to the Tylenol box. He opens it and takes 2 pills of Tylenol and swallow that. He could be depending on the Tylenol itself to heal him. Is that dependent on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is no dependence on Allah Azza wa Jal. Another person will take those Tylenol and he says, those are a cause for me to receive healing. And this cause could be suspended or could be what?